Today we're going to be showing you guys some TikTok tricks that are going to change the way you play Minecraft. Remember to give me a follow on TikTok and subscribe here to help us hit our goal of 6 million subscribers by the end of the year. All right, coming in at number one is something super cool that I had no idea actually worked, but apparently you can dye water inside of cauldrons now, which is super duper awesome. I didn't realize that. And on top of that, you can also use those dyed waters to dye leather armor for horses. So you can have dyed colored water and dyed leather armor. How crazy is that?
What?
I don't know if it's true, but let's see. So I think, Cap, you don't even need to do that. I think you take the dyes, you put them over top of one of these, right? So let's do light blue, yellow. We got a couple of them. Let's see. Oh, it's not working. This might be a bedrock only thing. Let's switch over and give it a try. All right, so we're on bedrock edition. We're going to give this a try. So first things first, do you have to put it in the water, I'm guessing? That is it. It does work. You put the water in the cauldron, and then you can go ahead and dye it whatever color you want. That's crazy. And then let's go ahead. Let's take the leather horse armor. No. Oh my gosh. Guys, it actually works. It actually dyes the horse armor.
What?
That's so awesome. See, even I learn something new every time I watch these. All right, coming in at number two is a chart that shows you exactly how you can dye different colored things to make up dyes that don't exist in Minecraft. I mean, it's not like you're making up colors. These colors are definitely real. It's just, I didn't realize up until now that you can merge colors together to make these different types of dyes. The big question is, however, can you do that in regular Minecraft or do you have to go over to Bedrock Edition? We're gonna have to try it out. Also, Cappy, what is going on up here? Alrighty then. Alright, so let's put it to the test here. So let's go ahead. We're going to make a yellow dyed tunic right there. And now can we go ahead and put other colors on it? We can! And it literally tells you what in the world? Okay, so if I have like, so that's a yellow one, right? What if I did with a little bit of light blue? Dude! It literally makes like a teal color. Like, look at that. I mean, it's not like bright teal, but...
Oh my god.
Did you know you could do this, Captain?
What?
What happens if I take that and combine with magenta? Dude, it becomes a poopier color. That's so awesome.
Bro. I didn't know you could combine dyes.
What? Yeah, dude. And I found a chart that shows you every single way to do it. There's so many different combinations, Steve. It's actually insane. In fact, it just follows. And look, it'll tell you the color code. And you can actually search these up online to see all the different color codes. I think you could do every single possible color that a computer can display, except in craft. That is madness.
That is.
Cap, can I give one of these boats a try? Woo! 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 How do you control it? Cap?
You don't.
It has a mind of its own. This is the worst idea ever. All right, so this next one is a really cool trick. I watched this one beforehand, and honestly, I was super impressed. I had no idea you could do this. The moral of the story after watching this is that there's a jump that normally you just can't make yourself. However, apparently, which I didn't realize, boats being their entity take fire tick damage, which just like a regular player in Minecraft will force it to stutter when in midair and taking that damage, allowing you to make it a little bit of a further distance when traveling over a drop, which, like I said, I'm gonna have to try this one out for myself to see it, kind of, you know, see it to believe it kind of thing. But what they're saying, I guess, kind of makes sense. Here it is. As you can see on screen there, he's doing it. Let's give it a try. All right, so we have this huge area up here. Just as our control, I'm gonna go ahead and jump as far as I can. Boom. And so we landed between these two blocks right here. So let me mark those with bedrock here. All right, we have our control group. Now we're gonna go ahead and try and light the boat on fire and see if this actually works. So first things first, let me just confirm that it does take tick damage. I'm sure it does. I just never really paid attention to it. Where did it just glitched through the floor.
Why is it? Did it glitch or does it?
It definitely glitched through the floor underneath.
No, it died.
There's some underneath it though, but I don't know. Okay, let me try something else. Can someone else light it on fire while I'm in it? Here you go. Here's a flint and steel. And then just put out the fire. So put it right underneath it, right underneath it, and then break the fire.
You fell through.
Let me just try it on the ground real quick. Let me just try this out real quick. See if it'll, it just automatically breaks it apart. So maybe you just have to be, and it broke it even while I was in it, right, Stead? So here, if you just apply that while I'm in it.
Yep.
The only thing I can think of is that this is something that only works in an older version of Minecraft. All right, so I loaded up to an older version of Minecraft, 1.13.2, to see if it'd work. And no, it does not work. So I don't know what is going on or why this isn't working for us. But if anyone has any ideas, please let us know. Well, because that one didn't work, Stead actually came up with his very own thing. So it's not really a TikTok so much as a little tip for you guys that even I didn't know about till recently. But Stead, how does it work, buddy?
So pretty much you give yourself a spawner or find a spawner out out in the world, and if you get a spawn egg, if you right click, you can change the spawn entity of the spawner.
Exactly. So if you're ever wondering how to get your very own custom spawners on your server, it's literally that easy. You just go ahead, grab yourself a spawner by doing Silk Touch, or you can literally, I think you can pull it out of Creative, right? No, you can't get out of Creative. So find the spawner, Silk Touch it. After that point, put the spawn egg on top of it, and that's what you get. Pretty awesome, Stead, honestly. I always wondered how people did it.
Yeah, it's really cool.
All right, this next one's gonna be really cool because it involves cauldrons and a brand new update that came out in one of the latest snapshots. So you go ahead, you put down a bunch of cauldrons, then you put lava all the way on top, you put the brand new stalactites on top of those as well, and eventually it creates an infinite lava source, which is something we haven't had in Minecraft since the very early days. I mean, seriously, you're probably wondering right now, like, wait a minute, was there ever a time? And yeah, actually, very early on in Minecraft's history, you can make an infinite lava source. All right, let's go ahead and try this out with a little bit of a smaller area. So we have this all set up just like that. Then we're gonna go ahead a little bit above it, and we will surround all this with some good old-fashioned stone. All right, there we go. And now we fill it all up with lava, and you put the dripstone right underneath it all. So hold on 1 second. Let's make sure we got this all covered up. All right, and dripstone, 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 dripstone. And it should start to fall through there into the cauldrons and accumulate over time. And hey, it finally worked. That actually took a little bit of time, probably about like a minute or so for the first one to pop up. But I can officially confirm it. It actually does work. So we have a brand new way. Now, if you just go over to it with a bucket, you can pick it up, and we have a brand new way, guys, to make infinite lava sources in Minecraft. How crazy is that?
That is awesome.
Dude, I love that.
Dude, infinite lava, though. How is Steve not all about this?
All right, this last one involves using different types of hotkeys on your keyboard, but they're super easy. It's basically all the different debug commands using F3. F3 and H gives you advanced tooltips, so it'll actually tell you the exact durability you have on a tool in case you were ever curious. F3 and A will reload chunks, so if you're ever lagging on a Minecraft server, or even a single player world, because let's say you've loaded up too many chunks, that's a surefire way to go ahead and just make it so it doesn't lag anymore. Now F3 and C that they just covered will allow you to copy and paste your coordinates so you can keep on moving later on to /TP and go from there. And lastly, F3 and F4 at the same time will allow you to open up a menu to choose between which game mode you want. So look at the first one, F3 and G. The use of chunks is actually super awesome and useful in Minecraft. You use it to help you do things like locate certain parts of a stronghold, or if you're playing on a server that has some things called chunk hoppers, or even in terms of mod packs like Feed the Beast, where you have things that'll load up different things within a chunk, it's good to know where the chunk starts and finishes. So F3 and G is definitely a good friend of yours.
What is the other one?
Now, F3 and A, you know, will work because it'll tell you that it actually reloaded all the chunks. And just in case, you'll also see this big flare, which...
It might not work, it might reloaded everything. Hold on.
And if you're wondering if it worked, you'll see a big kind of flare when it...
Okay, yeah, I think you have to... Because you just loaded it out.
So if you're wondering if it works, you can go ahead, run the command. It'll tell you in the chat that F3 and A was activated.
I think I might have hit a key too hard.
There we go. As you can see, F3 and A, boom, and the screen will flicker. That means that everything reloaded, and it should help with any lag you have.
F3 and H.
Now, if you have a pickaxe that has some durability loss and you don't know exactly how much, just hit F3 and H at the same time, and it'll tell you all about the different tools. So you ready? F3, H, shown, and boom, you can now see the durability of your weapon. Or equipment. I mean, whatever we're talking about here. Either way, you get the point, and you'll know exactly how much you have left. Now, F3 and C is something I just learned about right now, but it does copy-paste your location. So you can go ahead, copy and paste it, do /TP, and then...
Ooh, that worked.
So F3 and C actually copies your location. As you see right there, it says copy location to clipboard. And that way, if you want to teleport to it at a later time, you're ready to go. And last but not least, they give you F3 and F4, which allow you to shift between the different modes at a given notice. There's also one more that I like, where let's say you're going around, you're typing all sorts of nonsense in the chat, and you just want to clear it out. If you do F3 and D at the same time, it'll clear that out. And last but not least, another one as well that I want to add in is F3 and T. Well, go ahead and reload all your resource packs and textures. So if you've ever been playing Minecraft and all of a sudden you just don't hear noises and you're wondering what possibly could have went wrong, run F3 and T and it'll probably fix that up. And there you have it, everyone. Those are some TikTok tricks that'll change the way you play Minecraft.